A very, very warm welcome to all of you, even if it is a freezing day outside. Very warm Manchester welcome. I'm April McMahon. I'm Vice President for Teaching, Learning and Students here. And it's my huge pleasure to welcome you to these spectacular surroundings of the Whitworth Hall for today's graduation ceremony. The most special welcome, of course, is for our graduands. It's your hard work and your fantastic achievements that we are all here to celebrate today. Those achievements are all the more remarkable because we have been through incredibly challenging times, not just as a university community, but just as citizens of the world. You have shown by your success in those circumstances that you can cope with whatever obstacles the world might throw at you in future. Just by getting here today, frankly, you have already absolutely smashed it, so well done you. We are also delighted to welcome so many friends and family members and supporters. They couldn't have done it without you. I'm sure they know that, but you should know that too. You have been absolutely vital to the success of our graduands today. And I'm sure you're very proud of what they've achieved. We certainly are. Colleagues up here on the stage from their school, their faculty, are incredibly proud of what they have all achieved. And finally, a huge welcome to those colleagues who are here from school, faculty, and also out there around the hall, around the campus. We've got colleagues from all around the university, all kinds of different day jobs, and they've come here to make sure that you are all looked after on what I hope is a really special day for you. So for those of you who are graduating today, when you chose to study at the University of Manchester, you were making a decision to make your mark on the future, both for yourselves, but also for the greater good of society and the environment. And that's because as the first university to make social responsibility one of our three core goals, we encourage all our students to take part in transformational activities, which will be helping you in future to stand out, to consider your place in the world and to know that you can make a difference. So through your studies and your life at university, you will have gained the knowledge and the skills to find success and become responsible leaders of tomorrow. And of course, you'll have made strong, supportive friendships and relationships here. And I hope that those will sustain you and you will sustain them for many years to come. During your studies, in your own ways, you have all enriched the University of Manchester and made it a better place. So we're changing for the better because of you and your contributions. And therefore, we're here to celebrate your success in your studies, but we're also here to thank you and honour you because of those contributions that you've made. It might have been through volunteering, or leadership, or being part of a society, or supporting your own community. For some of you, it may have meant being part of Stellify, our program that supports students to develop the skills and attributes of a University of Manchester graduate. We believe that you are socially responsible, you're highly employable, and you are resourceful. And we know that employers all around the world really appreciate the value of a Manchester degree. We are the university that is most targeted by the UK's top 100 employers, for instance. So achieving this qualification is a massive milestone, and we're really delighted to be celebrating with you today. But this is the beginning, not the end, of your association with the university. You've still got access to our world-leading careers service, to our amazing libraries, and of course the Alumni Association will help you to make connections and friends and contacts in whatever part of the world you may choose to live and make an impact in. We have, after all, got 550,000 alumni all around the world. And as alumni, you are our best ambassadors. You can help tomorrow's students in so many ways through placements, employment, through supporting the university with its development. Now, coming back to today, please let me encourage you to enjoy yourselves. That is my only instruction on this occasion. Please have a lovely time. This is a real proper celebratory event. Friends, families, supporters, graduation is not really a spectator sport. So we would love you to join in, which means clap and cheer and make sure that we're really recognizing the huge effort that our graduates have put in. And to those who are graduating, oh, I can see nervy faces in the front row. Please relax. Hello, I see one of the nervy faces waving at me. Look how many of us there are. We are all here to help you get where you need to get to. You don't need to worry about it. We will get you in the right direction. There will be plenty of time to enjoy your moment. There will be no tripping and no slipping. You will come up the stairs and glide effortlessly across the stage. You will be absolutely fine. So have a marvelous day, and I sincerely hope that today will not be your last contact with the university. Please remember, our doors will always be open for you. But before we get you up here, we have a couple of very important speakers. And the first that I have the pleasure of introducing is our today's inspirational speaker, and that is Robbie Beale. And Robbie is the Activities and Culture Officer in our very own Students' Union. Robbie recently graduated in History and Politics from the University of Manchester, and he's responsible for leading our activities programme in areas like clubs and societies and volunteering and student media. He chairs the Manchester Academy Venues Board, and he's got special responsibilities to support international students. So please give Robbie a really warm welcome. Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me. I won't be too long, but well done before I go on to my speech, because I know how much hard work it has been to get here, but you have done it. I'm standing in front of you today not as an inspirational speaker, that's up to you to decide, but as a fellow student. As I mentioned, I was sat where you are now just a few months ago, and although Manchester does look very different in the cold, this all feels very familiar. Through all the speeches and ceremony, I couldn't help but look around at the room, smiling at my friends' faces in the crowd. My housemate, who I had written every essay side by side with, course mates who had unwittingly given me my whole essay argument in one sleepy seminar. Many of them are firm friends who I hope to never lose contact with. We smiled and chuckled as we all tackled the intimidating process of walking up these stairs. Word of warning, you may have done it before, but try not to get those big sleeves caught on the banister. Afterwards, you might wander outside and meet your friends' families. Even if you don't have loads of friends on your course, the flagstones and pathways of this campus will hold many memories for all of you, whether that is academic frustration, hard work, maybe even flashes of inspiration, there'll be plenty of memories to think about. Think about the lecturers who saved you hours of sleep with one reassuring email, but also think about everything you did outside of your course. All of you will have done a lot more here than simply getting a degree. We're here to celebrate your academic achievements, but you are part of societies, you volunteered your time for others, maybe you were a course rep, you worked a job alongside your studies, maybe you even got involved in the democratic processes of your wonderful students' union. Manchester is a brilliant and inspiring city to study in. Manchester split the atom, Manchester invented the computer, it invented trade unionism and the weekend, not the singer, but the actual weekend. What Manchester does today, the rest of the world does tomorrow, and it's up to us as students of Manchester to shape that tomorrow today. That housemate of mine is now working an amazing job in another part of the world. We chat on the phone every couple of weeks, and he crashes at mine when he's back in the country. I still keep up with everything that my old society gets up to, and you will too. I even go to the pub with those course mates to watch the football. The people who you meet here are worth so much more than a piece of paper, and the experiences that you've had of growing into a valuable part of society will shape you for the rest of your life. Now, I won't keep you any longer from getting that degree. Have a lovely rest of your day. The hard work really paid off.
Good afternoon. You have only one more speech to sit through before you get to graduate. My name's Professor Steve Jones, and I'm the head of Manchester Institute of Education. And I'm here representing your school today. That's a school of environment, education, and development. It's absolutely fantastic to have you here in Manchester to mark this important moment and to celebrate your degree success. You really deserve it. For those of you who are friends, family, and supporters of our graduates, welcome to the University of Manchester. And on behalf of my colleagues, congratulations to you all. Today is a culmination of much hard work and devotion, and you should be very, very proud of yourself. Getting into the University of Manchester is hard. Getting a degree from the University of Manchester is a major achievement. And getting a degree from the University of Manchester during or shortly after a pandemic is unbelievable. You overcame odds that were stacked against you. You coped academically with interruptions to your learning, and you coped emotionally under the most stressful of circumstances. You have a powerful story about your adaptability and resolve with which to impress future employers. You can also bore your children and grandchildren by telling them how COVID was no match for you. In 2020, together with a couple of colleagues in education, I broadcast a virtual graduation ceremony from this very room. The three of us stood right here on a stage in full regalia, wearing our gowns and our hats. We also wore face masks, and we kept far enough away from each other to stay socially distanced. It was a nice thing to do, and hundreds of students appreciated the gesture, but it was also a strange and slightly depressing experience. Three people and an iPad, all alone in this amazing space. Then outside to an empty, closed campus and a noiseless Oxford Road. Today is reminding me how great it is that we are fully open once again. Thank you for coming. The university is nothing without people. Let me tell you about the school from which you're graduating. We're famous for our research, from children's mental health to work on smart cities to activism around everyday austerity that blights people's lives to projects in the global south. SEED is known for the research that it undertakes. We're also not bad at teaching. I never teach my students, I only attempt to provide the conditions in which they learn, said Albert Einstein, who gave his first ever UK lecture in this very room about 100 years ago. We've tried to provide the right learning conditions for you, and I hope that you are stimulated, challenged, and energized by our teaching. But as staff, we can't take all of the credit. Let's be honest, most of you wouldn't be here today without the love and support of the people behind you, your family, your friends, your team. Some of those people are literally behind you, others may be watching online. Perhaps, graduates, you would like to join me in showing your appreciation for those who have stood by your side throughout your studies. Thank you. Research and teaching are two of the three goals, core goals of the University of Manchester. But as Professor McMahon says, Manchester uniquely has a third goal, which is social responsibility. And you're graduating from a school where the range of disciplines is diverse, but they all share one thing in common: a commitment to making genuine and meaningful difference to the communities around them. We try to make the world a better place. The great aim of education is not knowledge, but action, said philosopher Herbert Spencer. Right now, the world seems a delicate and scary place. Pandemic, war, climate change, all underline the fragility of human habitats. So much of the work that we do tries to help. This might be greener buildings, a cleaner environment, life-changing education, tackling inequality, or supporting development in the global south. The range of skills which you have developed in your studies means that you too are now equipped to play your part. In fact, the biggest impact that we make as a school is through you, our graduates. As a cosmopolitan, outward-looking, confident, and socially responsible future generation, it's now your turn to take the agenda forward. For this reason, we are especially keen to keep in touch with you after you leave the university. Our disciplines thrive on exchanges of ideas between academia and practice, and your lecturers want to continue conversations so that we can learn from your expertise and experiences. The end of your degree is not the end of your association with the school, and our doors are always open. Whatever your plans for the future, I hope that your degree has helped make the world a more interesting place. and I hope that you will now choose the right path. After all, it is not our abilities that show what we truly are, it is our choices. That was Dumbledore from Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. Thank you for coming today. There's nothing you can't achieve next. Everyone at the University of Manchester wishes you the very, very best. Well done.
Vice President, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you for the degree of Master of Arts in Digital Technologies, Communication and Education, Kajia Chun. Jia Chu. Maria Nicolina Dimitrilaki. Yuxuan Fu. Buena Jill Gillespo. Yashin Gua. James Thurston Hayworth. Tianling Jiang. Raijing Zhao. Xiaolin Li. Shishi Li. Chang Liu. Xianyu Ma. Sarah Mannix. John Paul Mills. Waiting Chi. Muang Jen Ren. Yuhan Wei. Yuk Wang Bernardo Wong. Shi Yuan Xian. Yen. Yutong Yen. Muang Yuan. Ke Jiang. Xiao Shui Ju. And in educational leadership, Qingyi Bai. Edward Salim Buono. Jiaxi Dong. Xinrei Gua. Ji Jing He. Wei Wei Lai. Shi Lu. Xinyue Peng. Jiaxian Wang. Qi Wang. Tan Yang. Xinyi Yao. Wenjia Yu. Cheng Cheng Jiang. Xinyu Jiang. Yue Jiang. Suaidze Jue. Lina Ju. Shinny Ju. And in educational leadership in practice, Tamara Maria Annunziata Baldacchino Britha. Bilal Fazl. Sean James Kelly. Sana Shahid Khan. Jin Young Lee. Jolene Amy Lewis. Shadlia Rose Neild. Shugra Inaitullah Rawoot. And in leadership in learning, Tyler James Bryce. Ruth Hannah Clark. Holly Crook. Beth Fidesz. Anita Galasso. Rebecca Joanna Jones. Rebecca Ann Newman. Phoebe Kate Singh. Oliver Stewart. Chloe Ellen Ware. Natasha Williams. Emma Wood. And in TESOL, Hong Yu Chun. Xue Dong. Yu Chun Jiang. Yu Ching Ching Lu. Noor Amalina Binti Miskin. Fan Young. Chun Yi Yao. And in TESOL Educational Technology, Stanislas Birami Fay. Tutu Nying. And for the degree of Master of Science in Research Methods with Education, Sunny Wu. Xin Ming Ju. And for the award of Postgraduate Diploma in Teach First Primary, Rebecca Ainsworth. Sakiba Akhtar. Kirsten Bond. Rihanna Borsley. Jordana Kate Buckley. Patricia Byrne. Rachel Dunnington. Aisha Ellison. Laura Heary. Rachel Honan. Sidoni Maguire. Elizabeth Wilding. And in Teach First Secondary Education, Washifa Begum. Nikita Gardner. Kate Kirby. Sophie Littler. Katie Mulvey. Rebecca Myers. Catherine Newborough. Jack O'Connor. Molly Rochford. Safia Veracchia. And in Teach First Secondary Geography, Claire Tuck. And in Teach First Secondary History, Caitlin Moore. And in Teach First Secondary Mathematics, Asma Desai. And in Teach First Secondary Science, Matthew Anderton. Harriet Dulson. Charlotte Marlowe. Jack Rees. Najman Sadiq Shah. Olivia Walker. Rebecca White. And in Teach First Secondary Spanish, Simona Capuano. Melissa Chan Cheap. Savannah Donahoe. Lewis Wright. And for the award of Postgraduate Certificate in Education, Michelle Clifford. Jack Hughes. And in Skit, Daniel Anderson. Zach Sala. Andrew Tui. And in Secondary Chemistry, Jenny Gillanders. And in Secondary English, Kimberly Ann Howard. And in Secondary French, Adam Scott William Taylor. And in Secondary Mathematics, Ellen Edwards. Charis Ruth Gates. George Thomas Hodgson. Christopher Mort. And in Secondary Mathematics School Direct, Thomas Fagan Hall. In Master of Science, Environmental Monitoring, Modelling and Reconstruction, Yuyan Wu. For the Postgraduate Certificate in Education, Komal Asan. George Child. And for Master of Arts in Educational Leadership, Chung Liu.
Well, before we do the small formal bit that we need to do before we can let you out, can I just ask everybody to give a huge round of applause for both our speakers and our presenter, because they did an amazing job. There now, that wasn't so bad, was it? From my point of view, it was great. I make that 5 hugs, 3 handshakes, 2 selfies, and nobody's hat fell off. So this is quite good. Graduates, I need to ask you to do a small amount of work. Can you stand up, please, today's graduates? And can you make sure that your tassel is on your left-hand side of your hat? And that is the sign that you are now officially a University of Manchester graduate. And when you came in here, you weren't. You were graduands. You were about to take your degree. And now you are the most recent graduates in the entire history of the University of Manchester. So that's pretty good going, isn't it? Now, at the beginning, Professor Jones asked you to applaud for your friends and family and supporters. Could I ask friends and family and supporters to stand up, please? Because I just have this instinct that you can do a better job than they did. Can I get you to applaud this amazing collection of graduates, please? Right, stay there. You can leave very shortly. Small formal bit first. On behalf of the university, I once again congratulate you all on your excellent achievements. I wish all our new graduates every success and every happiness in your future lives and careers. And I now declare this ceremony closed. Thank you very much.